Are you ready? Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
See, first of all, I would like to tell you why suddenly the government department or the central government, state government, now PR, Public Relations Society of India, why everyone is so cautious about entrepreneurship. Let me tell you, as per McKinsey report, by 2020, there are 55 crore people are going to be unemployed in our country. 555 million. And out of that, majority is graduate and above. And such a big problem, government cannot alone solve this problem. And if we, everybody become a job seeker, then who will be the job creator? People like you and me cannot evade or scale the responsibility of tomorrow. What is the solution? The solution is sustain and grow a small enterprises and develop more and more micro and small entrepreneurs. Because entrepreneurship has the power to lead people out of poverty and solve the unemployment problem. The business may be small, but the employment is huge. The non-corporate small business are the backbone of the economy and the largest contributor to the urban and rural employment. There are 5.77 crore registered enterprises, and unregistered is much more higher than that in our country. Also, as per earlier study, nearly 60% of SME in India fall within unorganized sector. This is the only reason, because those who are really small player, small entrepreneur, if they go for a registration, they've been harassed, they've been tracked, they have been misused to their company, their unit may be closed. That's why they avoid. The government is also made the simplification a lot, simplifying day by day. Now system is also improving, but still lot of improvement required for the registration and all. These small companies, their 45% contribution to national GDP and compared to 15% by the corporate sector. They provide 90% of employment in the country. Out of that, 46 crore employed, 24 crore self-employed. But most interesting part is the SSI sector mostly employ those who doesn't get job in the government department or corporate sector. They arrange the capital needed mostly on their own and spring up to meet the needs. What you call today's time is bootstrap entrepreneur. They do the business on their own money. In a country like us, we need to generate 1 crore jobs a year. Nurturing this business is a sure way of addressing this requirement. Despite generating a value addition of 6.28 lakh crore per annum, only less than 4% of this sector financial needs are served by banks. This is the reality. Whatever I said, but whatever I will say, It is a reality of today's scenario. Now what I'd like to tell you, where is the fun if you don't follow your dream? If I ask you, are you interested to follow your dream? Everyone will say, yes, I have followed my dream. I want to follow my dream. But if I ask you, how many did you follow your dream? Then people say, whatever the opportunity I got, whatever opportunity I have done that. I have seen, until and unless you follow your dream, then life has got a different charm. If you are really want to follow your dreams, for that, your profession and your passion should be your addiction. If you really want to follow your dream, for that, your profession and your passion should be your addiction. Like I tell you, little bit of example I would like to give you in every slide, every point. In very early age, because I lost my father very childhood, age of 7. In the early age, I was in swimming. I went to swimming because, so I thought, that I'll get, if I represent state, I'll get as age of 17, 18, I can get a bombing job. So when I started swimming, I was doing well, up to boys under 12 and all. So I realized, it is not a brain sports, it is a lot of strength and all. So I was not enjoying in fact. And I went to swimming because my uncle was an Olympian in swimming. So I switched over to table tennis, and within 2 years, I become Nepal champion, I become India number 3. So, as soon as I become Bengal champion, India number 3, I started getting all the government jobs, central government, the railways, the state bank and others. So I didn't find this is very lucrative job and this kind of job I was not looking for. I can't work like this. So I started my own venture, and early stage it was a lot of difficulties, but more and more later on it's become, life become more and more easier. So if you want to put your innovation, if you want to show you how innovative you are, how efficient you are, how creativity you have, you want to show, then you have to be an entrepreneur. If you go for a job and all, is a day-to-day job, you have to do it. So you cannot show your innovation, your creation and all this. In entrepreneurship, one thing I have seen, people always say, you require a lot of capital, but I tell you, capital doesn't matter. In entrepreneurship, people say, you need a lot of capital, but I tell you, in entrepreneurship, you don't require a lot of capital. Whatever capital you needed to start a small way in any venture, that much capital everyone has got. Capital doesn't matter. You just need a common sense to get a futuristic idea. What is futuristic idea? Which is logically correct, commercially viable, and different than others. And it has to play artistically or aesthetically. Then there are no work for risks. In entrepreneurship, always people say there are a lot of risks. I tell you, in entrepreneurship, there are no risks at all. In entrepreneurship dictionary, you will not find the risk word. What is risk? If you know what you are doing, it is always risk. If you don't know what you are doing, it is always a risk. And if you know what you are doing, it is never a risk. So you must know what you are doing. If you know what you are doing, it is never a risk. If you don't know what you are doing, it is always a risk. Like I am giving you an example, because I was state level, national level swimmer. So if I go to any swimming pool, even deep side, if I jump, nothing will happen. But if I go to Sundarban and I saw the river and going on, and if I jump, the alligator is there. So I must know where I am jumping, where I am diving. So you must know what you are doing. So there are no politics. Knowledge capital is ultimate capital. In entrepreneurship, the knowledge capital is ultimate capital. Financial capital is not at all capital. World is knowledge driven with technology based. That's why imagination is more important than knowledge. Knowledge is limited, but imagination encircles the world. Whatever you have, be happy with that. Then only your mind can reach to high. Where you come from is immaterial, but behavior and cool-headed is. Getting degree is not ultimate, but education is, because you cannot become a burden or liability for the society. Important to do things rather than thinking, because performance ultimate top. Be trendsetter, not trend follower, because you have to be different than others. Repeating the same mistake and expecting different results is insane. Everybody has got some hidden talent. Locate that talent is important. Most beautiful experience, what we can experience, is mysterious, because it is a source of all true arts and science. Maturity is when we understand ourselves. Difference between invention and innovation. You must know what is the difference between invention and innovation. Like I tell you, every innovation is invention, but every invention is not innovation. Until and unless any invention is commercially viable, it is not innovation. Like I am giving you an example, invention has got no value until and unless it becomes innovation. I am giving you a small example, like computer. When computer made initially, it was a building size, then it become a room size. As soon as it become a tabletop, it's become commercially viable. It's reached to everyone, house, everyone, office, everywhere. This is called innovation. Invention until and unless is converting into innovation, that innovation has got no value. Innovation is always superior than technology. Innovation is always superior than technology. Why I tell you, again I would like to give you an example, because time is very short, 25-30 minutes I have to complete everything. That's why I am going very short and very quickly. Innovation is always superior than technology. I would like to give you an example here also. In 1965 war, India versus Pakistan, those days, Pakistan has attacked India to Akhnoor sector and all. I don't want to go the war detail, but I would like to tell you the actual fact. So India, Pakistan attacked with 500 patent tank and 200 savages, and those days patent tank was impossible to destroy. But in the Punjab sector, patent tank being destroyed, one Willis jeep with LCA gun, one LCA jeep with RCL gun, Abdul Hamid, he was a Paramvir Chakra, Havildar Abdul Hamid, he destroyed with his jeep with 7 patent tanks. But it was impossible. If 10 crore rupees value of patent tank, then 10,000 rupees are with his jeep. The innovation, because due to maneuverability, one Willis jeep and Havildar Abdul Hamid was taking care particular point, so he proved the one jeep can destroy the 7 patent tank. It was unbelievable. No one can think about it. Now I'd like to tell you, wind power is always superior than any power. Why wind power is always superior than any power? I would like to give you an example. The one person was in Hungarian army. His name is Karoli. He was those days, in 1938, he was the best pistol shooter. And Hungarian national championship, the European all championship and all, he was winning. And it was sure shot that Karoli is going to get the Olympic medal in 1940. And Karoli practicing, and everyone is sure that Karoli is winning all the championship. There was some trial going on, practice going on in Hungarian army to throw one grenade. He lost his rifle. So after his treatment and all, he should have stayed in the house and then he said, I lost my right hand, so my life is no value and all. So after 1 month, he came back home. He thought, I lost my right hand, but I have a left hand, and I know how I have practiced with my right hand, how I have prepared my right hand. But the left hand, he's not in a position to sign, he's not in a position to lift a pistol properly, to load it, he has lost his this much hand. Then he started practicing with the left hand. And entire 1 year practicing, in 1939, he went to Hungarian national championship, and everybody thought in Hungarian national championship, the Karoli has come to miss us, to cheer us. So everybody is hugging Karoli and saying, this is called real sportsman spirit and all. But Karoli said, I didn't come. Karoli said, I didn't come to cheer you here. I have come here to compete with you. And after the national championship competition, you know who won? The weaker hand and only hand. The Karoli. After that, Karoli started practicing more and more for the 1940 Olympics. He was preparing. Due to the Second World War, the Olympic being cancelled. But he didn't leave his hope. He started practicing more and more. 1944, he was preparing for 1944 Olympics. 1944 Olympic also. Couldn't help because of Second World War. Again he continued up to 1948. And 1948, he won the gold medal. At that time his age was 38 years. In 28 years, he was in 1938. And after that, what he has done, he thought, none of them those days has taken the consecutively 2 years, the Olympic in pistol shooting. Again, 52 Helsinki Olympic, he participated and he won the gold medal. This is, he had a lot of excuses, lot of lame excuses. This is the reason I couldn't do, that is the reason I couldn't do. But he didn't give any lame excuses. This is entrepreneurship. You cannot give any lame excuses in entrepreneurship. If you have lost, that means due to you, you have lost. Starting block. See, start a venture, any venture, because PowerPoint presentation is not here. To start a venture, you need three things. Any venture. Product, contacts, and funds. If you have two, hard automatics comes. If you have product, if you have contacts, finance automatic comes. If you have contacts, if you have finance, product automatics comes. If you have product, if you have finance, contacts automatics come. If you have two, hard automatics come. And if anybody acquired two and started this venture, if he failed, I'll be responsible. He cannot fail. Anybody want to start his venture, and if he acquire two, and then he start, third automatic stop, he cannot fail. Create your identity. Create your identity, glory will follow. Because brand value is ultimate asset. How much money you make, how much property you make, that is not asset. Actual asset is brand value. I'm so and so son, I'm so and so daughter, this is not an identity. The people will say, you are so and so, he's so and so father, so and so mother, it's like that. If I ask you, do you know Sachin Tendulkar's father's name? Hardly any people can say. If I ask you, Sunil Gavaskar's father's name, hardly people can say. It is like that. You have to make your identity, then glory will follow. Because brand value is ultimate asset. How much money, how much property you made, that is not asset. Aim for zero waste and minimize overhead, because when cost control ends, then cost reduction start. Art of purchase is very essential to sell your product. Until and unless you know the art of purchase, you cannot sell your product. The product you are buying, the material you are buying, the right material and right price. Marketing ultimate build the leader. Product strength, there also I believe three-word marketing. I know it's a public relations society of India. I should not speak like this, but I believe in three-word marketing, that is product strength. I don't believe in thick marketing book. I believe in three-word marketing. And public relations society, in this platform, I should not say this word, but I always say everywhere. The product strength is ultimate strength. Price marketing is ultimate marketing. And whisper publicity, the word of mouth we call, is ultimate publicity. Like Ganeshji would be that. You are spending money and highlighting the people. Packaging is part of product. Promotion by satisfaction and sell through both offline and online in today's time, which is called omnichannel. Because e-commerce has now become the new driving force of growth for small and medium enterprises in India, and has been a major contribution to new job opportunities and to the GDP. As per available data, the e-commerce sector in India is projected to cross 80 billion by 2020 and will account for 2.5% of India's GDP by 2030. Right guidance and prompt service to your customer. The segment you want to play, just place the ball on that segment and do the dimension analysis. Everybody, every product industry is service industry, and every service industry is product industry. People say, I am from service industry, you are from product industry, is not right at all. Every product industry is service industry, every service industry is product industry. The service you are giving, that is your product. After that, like what you have a software manufacturer, that is a product. The software area, after that you have to give service. I am selling a product, that is my product. After that I have to give service. After the product selling is just a first step. After product selling, if customer is not satisfied, it is your responsibility. The customer should be years after years to use your product and have full confidence whatever he is using. That's why I say every product industry, service industry, every product, service industry is product. Castle and chair. Any strategy is a 3T strategy. The techniques, tactics and tricks. Techniques, tactics and tricks. Technically, you have to be very strong. Tactics mean your skill has to be very sound, and tricks, you must do the tricks. People say be always proactive. I say sometimes reactive is no harm. Like I am giving you example, the World Cup football final, the France versus Italy, the way Zidane being out from the ground, enter 45 minutes, first half, second half, 90 minutes, Zidane was control himself, but after the 90 minutes, he could control himself. In the extra time, he hit with his head with his opponent player, and he's out from the ground. As soon as he's out, they have given the goal and they won the World Cup. So there are no harm to use the tricks, be a reactive. Your strategy is your insurance for certainty. Your strategy is your insurance for certainty. Only thing is certain, that is uncertainty. Only thing is certain, that is uncertainty. There are no wall for certainty in entrepreneurship. Visualization for sustainability, probability for uncertainty, credibility for reliability, capability to get information, capability to get information, agility for eligibility, cannibalize your own product for disruptive innovation. You must know how to cannibalize your own product for disruptive innovation. Like, I would like to highlight an example here, like Kodak company. Kodak company, by making film, they become the second largest film man. They become a second largest company in the world by making the film. But they were the first person who introduced a digital camera. They invented. They didn't introduce, they invented. They did not introduce in the market. They thought that it will be complete with our film. But slowly, slowly, when other company came, and film become absolutely production being stopped, then they came with the digital camera. So you must know, cannibalize your own product for disruptive innovation. A small step leads to antidote for recession effect. So if you take this small step, whenever the problems come, small step, then there will be no recession. Entrepreneurship is the biggest social service because entrepreneurs has outperformed the innovation and actual art of living. Why? Learn himself and protect others. Availability of essential commodities. Generate employment and develop skilled workers. Develop ancillary and create entrepreneur. Develop ancillary unit and create entrepreneur. Give revenue and earn foreign exchange. Support other industry by procurement and supply. Charm of living an entrepreneur to know your value. If you really want to know your value, then become entrepreneur. Why it is art of living? The entrepreneur life is day to day is like that. Now is absolutely okay. Suddenly the size people came, suddenly the bad people came. So your mood is off, this, that. Whatever the situation, living in the favorable or unfavorable situation is called part of living. If you really want to know your value, then become entrepreneur. Why it is art of living? The entrepreneur life is day to day is like that. Now is absolutely okay. Suddenly the size people came. Suddenly the bad people came. So your mood is off, this, that. Whatever the situation, living in the favorable or unfavorable situation is called part of living. And smiling in all those situations is called part of living. That's why I always say, enjoy entrepreneurship. Thank you. Any question? See, I tell you, so far small entrepreneurship concern, I have developed in UNDP project in National Center for Youth Diversification. Today is a National Youth Board, Ministry of Textile. Not in hundreds, in thousands. Small entrepreneur, they are doing very well. Now, people take me to Vinod Gupta School of Management, IIT Kharagpur, then IFT and all. Every day, some of the FB classes, some of the students are coming. I always give them whatever support I can, in every extent, when monetary, this, that, everything extent. But whoever is sure shot, sure success story, I just tell them, you can go ahead. I always believe, don't take a chance, don't take a risk. And everybody cannot become an entrepreneur. It is true. Out of this class, out of this I won't say class, out of this platform. If 4-5 people become entrepreneur, the other automatically gets the jobs. So those who are real talented, innovative, they should come forward and take this initiative and become entrepreneur to show the world what you can do. Thank you.